We've used cube maps for skyboxes and environment maps for sharp and glossy reflections and for refraction. It turns out we can even use the same mechanism for diffuse lighting. For these previous techniques, we needed the direction to the eye and the shading normal in order to compute a reflection or a refraction ray. For the diffuse component, we just need the shading normal. Remember, the diffuse component doesn't depend on the eye's direction. We used the dot product between the normal and the light source vectors when we computed the effect of a single light on the surface using Lambert's law. Now think big. For a particular point on a surface, consider every texel in our environment map as a source of light, emitted or reflected. Take the dot product of the direction vector to each texel from the surface and compute the dot product with the surface normal. Add these all up. You now have the contribution of the entire environment map on a single location. You might think doing this is a bit expensive to do for every pixel we want to illuminate, and you'd be right. Doing this properly is a good task for path tracing. However, there are a few things working in our favor. First, once you've computed the sum of all the contributions of all the texels for one point on one surface, you've actually computed it for all points with the same normal direction. Remember that the environment map is infinitely far away, so what's true for one surface normal is true for them all. The other element working in our favor is that a cube map can be used to store the results of our computations. After we compute the sum of all the contributions for a given normal, we then simply store this value directly at that location in the cube map texture. This texture is called the diffuse environment map, or irradiance map. Now when we want the sum total lighting for the surrounding environment for a given normal, we just look it up in the cube map. One other advantage we have is that the diffuse map can be quite low resolution. While this original sharp environment map had cube faces that were 512 by 512 texels, and our gloss map was 128 squared, the diffuse map is usable at only 32 by 32 texels. Nonetheless, it can be expensive to compute the diffuse map, so what we do is the same as for the glossy map. We compute the texture in advance with some image processing software. This gives us the texture we need to light the scene. During rendering, we just use the shading normal to find the overall contribution of the environment's lighting to the surface fragment.